Okay, we're back, we're live. What I'm going to show you how to do now is wrap a seamless liner. And this is one of Frank's pre-primed liners specifically for doing a seamless wrap. And the thing about this is that they put the primer on after the wood is joined. You can see here that there's no real visible miter, which is what you want. If you were to join four legs of a primed liner, you would need to go back in and touch up the corners so that the seam in the liner didn't show through the fabric, which it will. But in this case, this is nice and smooth. You probably can't really see it, but this actually has a very slight contour to it. Very slight, so it's not totally flat. So what we're going to do now is we're going to roll glue just like before on the liner. We're going to put the fabric on it. This of course does not go into the press, and so we're going to put the fabric on with the glue slightly tacky, and then we're going to turn it over. We'll trim it, and then we'll trim out the inside. We'll add glue to the lip and then roll it around and then finish it off and finesse it on the inside. And so on that note, that's what we're going to do. And here we go. So now we're gonna come over to our glue and using the same roller. And as I mentioned before, there are these rollers here. These work really nicely. They give you a really fine layer of glue. Sometimes these little pink fibers come off, so that could be an issue. I wouldn't recommend using one of these for the white sheer silks. But for our nice hot pink, it could totally work. But I'm just going to keep on using this this roller here for what we're doing. And since we have a bright color, it's not so critical not to get any little specks in here. I already cleaned the roller off on this piece, and you can see that there's some specks on there. But for this color, it's not as critical. So we're going to come over here on this little liner. And as I mentioned, there is a slight curve with this. It's almost imperceptible, but basically we're just gonna go same as before, nice and smooth. And we're just putting glue on the face. That's all we're doing right here at this moment. You don't really wanna goop it over onto the sides. But we will, I'll show you here, we will put it on the edge, on the inside edge. And for this little liner, we're going to get our paintbrush out again. There we go. So it's just a nice even coat, and that's going to be that. And then we're gonna take our paintbrush. Because this is such a small liner, I'm just gonna go in here, if you can see that, on this part. And quite frankly, I'm not going to leave this particular surface out, but conceivably, since this is such a small area right here, I'm not going to suggest that you leave it out, but conceivably you could. But for this demonstration, I am going to include it just for the full depth of our experience here. We're going to do this as we go along. And again, we will also do the rabbit. Just nice and tidy. And then for this, because this glue is going to be still tacky when we fold it over, try to get this around so you can see it. We're just going to come in here. We're going to fold it over, and this is where your tacking iron comes in really nicely. I'll just come in here like this. And you could, if you had a big liner, you could probably, with some practice, you could probably hit the lip of the frame with just the edge of your roller, but it's nice to get a, use a small paintbrush, and then you can really work it right up in the rabbit. So when you trim it, it's nice and tidy on the inside here. And I think that's good. Just like so. There. There we go. Just sit that there. And I'm going to make sure you don't have any strays on this. Then this is still pretty tacky here, but it's not totally wet. You can come and put this over like so. And on these small ones, it's pretty easy. And then basically, you're going to use your bare hands. If you get any little bubbles, you just work it right out into the middle or out to the side, like so. And you just keep working it. Like so. And what you can do, gently, you can just kind of work it with your fingers. You can work it a little bit. You don't want to put a lot of aggressive pressure with your burnishing bone on fabric, just because it can get shiny. You don't really want to disturb that, but you just keep working it like so, pushing it down. And again, similarly to the mats, you're making a premium product, and so you need to include the time that you're going to put into doing these in your pricing. And that's a whole conversation right there. But you can see how this is pretty nice and smooth now. And conceivably, and this is kind of, you know, this is kind of another deep dive. You could take another piece of fabric. You can't feel this, but I can. I can feel how this is cool to the touch because the glue is still a little moist, but not moist enough to soak through. Conceivably, you could take another piece of fabric and put on top of here for protection from this. And with some expertise, you could actually run your tacking iron on top of here with fabric on top to protect it. I don't recommend that to a beginner, but it is possible to do it. If you're starting out, best just to do it like I'm doing it, because then you can really have control over this and just keep smoothing it out. And this is super nice here, and we're going to trim off the outside. And it's easy to do because you've got this wooden surface to use for a straight edge, and just come on down like that. Again, sharp blades are the key. You can see how it just cut it right off right there. I like to put my finger down so I can keep it from pulling the fabric like that. Rotate this around. And like everything that has to do with what we're doing with all of these fabrics and frames and liners, it's just a matter of practice. By the way, speaking of all the possibilities that you can do with fabrics, you can actually wrap frames, certain profiles. This little liner here, conceivably, it could even act as a frame for something. There's just myriad possibilities that you can do. So this is all ready. We're gonna trim out the middle in the pretty much the same way that we did for the mat. Same idea, and basically with a thicker edge here, it is possible to get a little gap, but we're gonna do our best to avoid that. And so what I'm gonna do with this, when I cut it, I am not going to come up quite as close right off the bat like we do when we're trimming up to the corner of a mat. I'm just gonna leave a little bit more distance. And here, right across, and just finesse this right up. And as I mentioned, this surface here conceivably, because it's so small, you could leave out the glue layer right on this surface and just put it in the rabbet. In the lip, because when you push it back, it's going to tighten it up right there anyway. But for the sake of this demo, I wanted to give you all of the info that you could possibly need and more. Come back on this side.
That totally obscures the camera.
Yeah, here you go. And do not get in the way. And you just come back this way. Like so. And again, with this awesome tacking iron, you can really push it and get a nice edge right there. Which is super nice. That. And then you take your nice sharp blade and you go right into the edge and you trim that out and then pull this off. You might get some threads happening. That's okay. Basically, it comes off really nice.
thusly. I'm just going to keep going. That's another thing you don't want to do. Is get schmutz on your tacking iron. This may or may not get included. Welcome to reality TV. This is what happens when you leave your tacking iron a little bit too close to a pair of pliers.
Ah.
Burned the rubber. You can tell that's how hot these babies get. And you get schmutz on your tacking iron, and look what happens. You get schmutz on your mat.
Uh-oh.
But look, it comes right off. Because the thing is, nothing bad ever happens on reality TV. Like this. This is going to come in just like that. So what you want to do, if you haven't done this before, which I hope, like I said, I hope there's people watching this that have never done this before. You want to get proficient with it, like all of these steps. You want to get proficient before you try to get fast, because there's no point in being fast if you're not proficient at it. So all of these little futzy things that we're doing, once you get it down, you can work on your speed, but this isn't about being fast anyway. It's about being good. And all of these details. So if you were, for example, I just was thinking about this, if you were using a fabric that was really sensitive, like velvet, if you wanted to use velvet to wrap a mat or a liner, velvet has a real soft and delicate surface that could be altered by doing exactly what I'm doing right now, using a tacking iron. You wouldn't want to use a tacking iron on the front if you were wrapping a liner with velvet. You would want to just use your hands.
Would you use that little tool? Frank's tool to get into the corners?
Yeah, you could. You could use Frank's plexi tool to push the fabric into the corners. If this was velvet, you don't want to use anything like the tacking iron. You just want to totally do it with your fingers. Similarly, I just thought of this too, if you were wrapping a mat that was going to go in your press with velvet or something really delicate that could be marked a suede board, you know, not suede board, but suede material. There are some fabrics, even like this really awesome silk that has this texture on one side that's different than the other. This stuff is awesome. This being wrapped on a mat, if you put it in the press, gluing normally, this texture can lose a little bit of its awesomeness, its shine. So often what I will do when I get the mat all ready to go, I'll take another piece of silk or linen or something soft, or even a piece of velvet, and put it on top facing down, and then put the release board on top of that. So the release board isn't pressing with the heat right on the surface of your fabric. And that will keep the awesomeness of this delicate texture, just like it looks right here I've even taken boards and mounted fabric on them, or use a piece of suede board, you know, and use that on top of the mat, and then the release board goes on top of that, because some of these textures can be, I wouldn't go so far as to say ruined, but you want to keep it as nice as possible. So that's a little side note, because there are so many awesome fabrics that you can use in framing. See, this just cut, you cut this right out. And if it starts to pull up a little bit, you can just take your tacking iron and put it right back down like so. But this is a really good, all of this handwork, this is part of the craft of making a premium framing product. And it's important to, once you've done this a little bit, you know how long it's going to take, all the steps that are involved. You definitely want to include that time in your labor charges. Here we go, let's make sure that's all good. And that's another great thing about the fabric glue, is that even after it dries, you can come back in and reactivate it. If you were really speedy doing this and got to this place where you're wrapping the lip while the glue was still tacky, you could just do it with your fingers. But the point is not to have to be, not to feel like you're in a race with this. But you can see how there's a little gap right there. That's pretty typical. It's just because of the width of the lip. And typically that is something that you could plan on based on the color of the fabric. You could touch this up before you put the fabric on. And there we have it. Okay.